Welcome back to TGK TV. This is your host, TGK. And in today's episode, I talk about Dak Prescott's interview at USA Today, where he talks about contracts and money. Check the clip out real quick.
I know that you're in a contract year, and you know Tom Brady, over the course of his career, I think records say like he saved the Pats like $60 million. He's obviously the GOAT, right? He's making like $15 million, I think, base salary. Yeah. Which other quarterbacks are making like almost double that, which is crazy.
Nobody's wife makes as much money as his wife does either. So make sure we know that, all right? Make sure we know that.
That's a good point. That's a dual income household
exactly.
There.
Exactly. When Tom Brady isn't the breadwinner in the home, then that's a great problem to have. So in that case, he can do that. He can you know, do his contracts however you want to do them. But for me, it's about I've got a great agent. I'm going to just let him do what he's best at and just leave it at that.
Do you have conversations with him about like, hey, I need to be taken care of, but like we need to make sure that there's flexibility for my guys like Amari and Zeke and Byron Jones to get taken care of as well?
We've had conversations, me and Todd, about just kind of, I guess, the way he's going to attack it or the way it's going to go down or however you want to say it. But I think he knows how to get what's deserved. And I think the team knows how to pay what's deserved and pay those other people at the same time what's deserved without being frugal.
So you're not uncomfortable going into a prove-it year and making sure that 2019 is like a tone setter?
Yeah, I mean, as I said, whatever's best for me, for my team, for my group, I guess, is what it is. And if that means going into that, we'll see what happens. But I'm going to take the advice from my agent and my team, and we'll figure it out.
All right, guys, so I hope you enjoyed that clip. It was Dak Prescott, you know, talking about his future with the Cowboys and how he views, you know, Tom Brady's contract. And, you know, you could take a little bit away from that and apply it to what you think his mindset is going to be for the Dallas Cowboys and his contract moving forward. I do want to point out, I'm going to have three points of emphasis in the way I approach this video, because when we're talking about a man's money, it's different, you know. I'm not here to judge how much a man should be paid or whatever the case may be. But I will take it upon the perspective of a fan and what I want my team to do, what I think the organization will be thinking and what they should do and what Dak Prescott should want. So I'm going to kind of eliminate me from trying to talk about a man's money and just lay out these three items of how it should be looked at and prefer to be on three separate ways, because three different sides to this fence is going to have three different outcomes. Now, when it comes to Dak Prescott, he's an awesome guy. I've never disliked him. I relate to him and his mother's story, because I'll share something. My mom passed away from cancer as well back when I was 9 years old. So I relate very much so to Dak Prescott, and I always applaud him for being as strong as he is and sharing his story about his mom. I know it's a sensitive topic, so I very much respect Dak Prescott, and I like him as a person a lot. So I separate that. I have to separate my like for the person he is and solely talk about the quarterback and the skills that he has as far as the assets, so to speak, right? Now, the points of emphasis that I wanted to go over are Dak Prescott's perspective. In that clip, he is completely right that, you know, without saying it, he said it, he deserves to get paid. And I am in no position to say he doesn't. I mean, he does have the wins to show for it. He does have years where he had a great QBR and a great quarterback rating. His touchdowns are up there with the top because of the rushing touchdown aspect. I mean, Dak Prescott has had two out of three great years. This third one was great because of the second half and how it moved on with Amari Cooper. So from Dak's perspective, there's really nothing we can argue with, right? Put yourself in his shoes. If you're a quarterback, you're only getting paid $500,000 to $700,000 a year, and all these quarterbacks that ain't even doing half of what he does are getting $5 to $20 million a year, then, you know, it's time to pay me. But in my mind, I'm pretty sure he's thinking, don't just pay me 10 to 15 million, give me 30, you know? So he wants to get paid. And as far as how you determine how much he should get paid, it should be based on what you think his trajectory level is going to be. So that's where, whenever I talk about it from a fan's perspective, that's gonna be different. From an organization perspective, I'm gonna keep saying the word perspective a lot, so I'm sorry if I get annoying, but it's just my raw thoughts. It's straight off the dome. I have no notes anywhere, straight off the head. So from an organization side, I didn't use a word that time. From Jerry Jones' side, you're gonna have to make a decision whether you pay Ezekiel Elliott or Dak Prescott, because if you pay both, you're really gonna screw yourself up as far as building a team around one of those players. Now, if you choose Dak Prescott and you decide to play the little game with Zeke Elliott, then why not trade Zeke Elliott right now and go get you a first round pick and get back in the first round? I think the thing is, there's multiple ways to approach it. It's just the organization is going to have to make a choice. And if they sign both, which I think is the wrong choice, to like big time contracts, then we're shooting ourselves in the foot, because a year from now, big time contracts are going to be due. Jalen Smith, you're going to have all the cornerbacks. You probably going to have an offensive lineman due. You're going to have a lot of stuff coming up that you're going to want to keep all these players, because these players at their position, they're better at their position than Dak is at his. Okay, so if you were to tell me that, for example, Zach Martin or Travis Frederick or DeMarcus Lawrence or Byron Jones or Jalen Smith or Vander Esch aren't better at their position than Dak is at his in comparison to their positions, then you're crazy, okay? For the sake of argument, I feel that players deserve to get paid as far as their value to the team in regards to their abilities. Now, one can argue, well, damn, Dak got everything to show for it. I'm not here to argue. He's been to the playoffs twice. He's won us a playoff game. I can't argue if you want to pay the man. Now, from a fan's perspective, if I'm thinking, trying to think logically and what I want the best outcome to be is to allow both of the Zeke Elliott and Dak Prescott to play their final year. But with saving the money that they're going to save, they can spend it on other key players to maximize the window that we have right now, because right now we have a solid group, and if we could just add more solid players to this group, then we can make a run at the Super Bowl. A Super Bowl victory next year, to me, is all that matters. We win a Super Bowl, and then we can worry about signing the players. We still have them for a year, and then after the year, after you've made your adjustments, you made your cuts, you can then go and sign Dak Prescott to the big contract, or even sign Ezekiel Elliott. And I'm still going to stick with either you're going to keep one or the other. You can't keep both at this point. So it's a tough thing when it comes to talking about money and contracts, and it's because we've become more educated with how the money system works with the cap space. I mean, everybody that plays Madden, don't tell me you're not there trying to figure out, you know, who to pay. I should pay this person early, front load their money, because by year 3, 4, 5, and 6, They're gonna be underpaid in comparison to when I gave them that contract, when they were overall rating of 75 versus year 6, they're overall rating of 98, but they're 35 years old and it's time for them to retire. So you're playing with all these contracts and trying to figure out when is the best time to give it to them. Either you front load it, back load it, however the case may be. It is really one of those tough situations for everybody involved, for the fans, for the Cowboys organization, and the players themselves, Dak Prescott. So to me, did I take any offense to the video? Not really. When he said that the naysayers are outright comical, well, I guess I'm one funny son of a gun, you know what I'm saying? You know, it is what it is. You know, I can say what I want, Dak can say what he want, everybody can say what they want, and as long as you just keep it clean and keep it, you know, in a formal way, you know, there's nothing wrong to having your opinion. So again, I think Dak Prescott, in a way, deserves a contract. I just don't know if the contract that I think he deserves is the one that he thinks he should get. And I'm thinking more of a team-friendly contract to maximize the potential of winning, because Dak Prescott is not a transcending talent. He does not have a talent that is far better than everybody else in the league. Therefore, to me, he is an average player with an amazing core. Now, if you give an average player transcendent money and his team is now below average, can he lift you up? And I cannot see that. I don't feel that. I don't have any faith or or even see the potential in that. I think Dak is a really good quarterback to maintain a good team, so therefore we should pay that maintenance to maintain the good team. It's been your boy TGK. Let me see your comments. I want to see what you think. What's your perspective? Do you agree? Do you disagree? I know my homie Mark Holmes believes you shouldn't worry about it. He should just get paid, you know, and we all have different perspectives. But I really want to see what y'all think out there and how you think the Dallas Cowboys should really approach this offseason. It's going to be a really, really interesting one. And I can't wait to see how it plays out, whether I'll be unhappy or happy. It's left to be determined. It's been your boy TGK. I'm going to catch y'all on the next one.